Are you thinking about getting an Ender 3 3D printer? Well, you might want to check out the Creality Ender 3 V2. They just announced this machine. It's not available till June, but they are taking pre-orders. It's got some nice features. It's a little more expensive than the current Ender 3s. So we're going to cover those features and help you decide whether to buy now or buy later right here at Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. If you look at the V2, it's really an upgrade to the Ender 3 Pro. It's got a Meanwell power supply, although mounted to the bottom. So instead of the back, it's underneath part of the electronics. It's got the control board mounted upside down, just like the Ender 3 Pro. It's got a wider base for the bed, just like the Ender 3 Pro. What it doesn't have is this magnetic bed. I was never a big fan of that. They've gone to a glass bed. I like that feature. There's a few features they've added, which you can find in my videos now, and you can get from the community. One of them are these adjusters that go on the X and the Y to keep the belts tight. They're very, very handy. I have it on the machine back here. I did a whole video on it, but that's something you can buy now. Another thing they've added is a knob up here on the extruder, just like I have here. You can 3D print that. That's not a big deal. Another thing they have on the front is a drawer here. This space is filled with a drawer so you can store little tools. There's different designs on Thingiverse. They've added that to this machine. One feature I really like is they've added the silent board to this. Now they're saying it's new electronics, so it may be an improved version, but you can get a Creality silent board for this machine right here. It converts to the 2208 drivers, which are a lot quieter and makes the printer print a little bit better. So it's definitely worth it. $30 to $50 is depending on where you buy it. And I've done a video on that. In fact, several of my machines have it. Big difference. So the fact they put it on this machine, I've been asking for that for a while. Fantastic. Now, whether they've gone to the 2209 drivers, and that's why it's new electronics, and there's different ways to drive those, we'll have to see. They're not giving us those details yet, but I really like the fact there's a silent driver on here. Another change you may notice is the control box. It looks a lot like a Prusa Mini, but it's got icons instead of the text and crude graphics on the current machine. But it's not touch. You still have a knob that you have to turn and select. And I hope they keep this open source so we can still have access to that if we have to update the machine. They don't give the full specs yet, so I don't know if the build area of this guy is the same as this guy. I assume it is. They also claim 30% more efficient cooling, so maybe that'll give a little higher temperature range for the hot end. Now, what I didn't see him change is the extruder top. It's still the plastic extruder top, which comes on machines now. If you buy one of the latest machines, they do now have a metal insert going into that arm so the filament can't rub it, which was the part of the reason I put the filament on the side. So that's carried over to this guy. But they have an upgrade kit where they give you Capricorn tubing, a metal extruder top, and then the silent board. So they put the silent board on there, but they didn't put the Capricorn tubing or the metal extruder. Why? I don't know. So I did contact my Creality representative and asked them about adding those two. I'd probably put an easy R on mine anyway, but to me, if you're going to do a V2, it should at least have the upgrade kit you recommend. So I hope to get one of these before the June release because it's awful hard to test a virtual machine like this. But with the glass bed, I wonder if that's going to deteriorate the prints because glass beds do tend to be heavier and so you get a little more ringing in your prints. So we'll see if they sorted that out. So I'm excited to try it out, but now the big question, is it worth the $289 list price? And you can buy one right now for $269 on their site as a pre-sale, which is $60 more than the standard Ender 3 and $30 more than the Ender 3 Pro. So is it worth waiting and then pay that extra? I don't know. That's a tough one for me to call because a lot of the stuff that this has, you can add to a machine now. So it'll be interesting when there's more specs out, what we find out about the electronics, the build size, things like that, to see if there's other improvements that I'm missing. But I just want to let you know that this exists. Go check it out at the Creality site. I'll put links to all this stuff in the description below. That's it for this week. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.